Hi kids, now you are going to learn about SARC. SARC means South Asian Association for the Regional Cooperation. It was established on 8th December 1985 for the promotion of economic and social progress, cultural development within the South Asia region and also for friendship and cooperation with other developing countries. The initial member, that means founding members of SARC are Bangladesh, Bhutan, India, Maldives, Nepal, Pakistan and Sri Lanka. Afghanistan, it joined as the 8th member on 3rd April 2007. The basic aim of the organization is to accelerate the process of economic and social development of member states through joint action in the agreed areas of cooperation. That means the member countries, in the member countries, economic as well as the social development, definitely it should be done through the SARC. The SARC Secretariat was established in the Kathmandu on 16th January 1987. The first summit was held at Dhaka in the year 1985. Dhaka, it is the capital of the Bangladesh. In that place alone, the first SARC summit, it was held there. Okay. SARC, it meets once in 2 years. Actually, 19th SARC summit, it took place in Pakistan, Islamabad. Okay, in Murray and Islamabad. But it was boycotted by the member countries due to the ill treatment of the Prime Minister of Pakistan. So the 20th SARC summit, that means in the next year itself, it was hosted in the Sri Lanka in 2018. Actually 2017 only, 2 years once only I said the meeting it will held, isn't it? But 2017 only they planned for the 19th SARC summit, but that SARC summit alone, it was boycotted by the people of, that means all the other member countries, due to the ill treatment of the whom? Pakistan Prime Minister Imran Khan. So the next year itself, the another SARC summit, it was held in the Sri Lanka. Okay, what are the objectives of the SARC? We will see that. To promote the welfare of the people of South Asia and improve their quality of life. To accelerate economic growth, social progress and cultural development in the region of the member countries. All the member countries, there should be 8 member countries, I told, isn't it? In that member countries, economic it should be grow there. Social progress should be there. Cultural development also should be there. To promote and strengthen collective self-reliance among the countries of South Asia. To contribute to mutual trust, understanding and appreciation of one another's problem. That 8 members, they should appreciate in between them what are the good things they done, as well as they should discuss about the problems, what the issues it is going on in between the countries, otherwise inside the countries, everything they may discuss and come to one solution. To promote active collaboration and mutual assistance in the economic, social, cultural, technical and scientific fields. To strengthen cooperation with other developing countries. To strengthen cooperation among themselves in international forums on matters of common interest. That means everybody, they should have the common interest in the, what is that one, in the economical development in the international level, as well as they should be in the cooperative manner. Whether in the SARC, Pakistan is there, Sri Lanka is there, Nepal, isn't it? Other than that, no problem. But Nepal, Pakistan, Sri Lanka, whether they are really in the friendly manner with us? No, not at all. When one person, that means when one country, it is signing in the foreign policy, it should not harm to the other country which is involved in that foreign agreement, okay? That foreign policy agreement. But here, everything it's going only on the theoretical way only they are signing there. In the practically, not there. Practically, they are not showing any friendly relationship. To cooperate with international regional organization with similar aims and purposes. What they are saying, they should cooperate together for the international and as well as the regional organization. Regional organization are SAARC, Asian, BRICS. These and all comes under the regional organization. International organization, UNO, is the international organization. That means all these member countries, they should cooperate among them for the development of this international organization as well as a regional organization. Functions of SAARC. What are the main functions of the SAARC? Maintenance of the cooperation in the region. Prevention of common problems associated with the member nations. What are the member nations? They are having the problem, common problem. It should be prevented. Before itself, it should be prevented. Actually, with us and Pakistan, always the border problem. Nowadays, the Nepal, they started for the border problem. It should be solved there. It should be prevented before we are waging a war. That means there should not arose any war. Due to that purpose alone, they are forming this type of the regional organization. Ensuring strong relationship among the member nations. Removal of the poverty through various packages of programs. Prevention of terrorism in the region. Prevention they are saying from the terrorism. Pakistan, whether they are not encouraging the terrorism, they are only the people, those who are the encouraging terrorism most probably, isn't it? They are spending most of their money only in the terrorism. That means what they are doing, they are encouraging the people for the terrorism. But it should be avoided if they want to get the friendly relationship with all the countries. Next, what are the achievements it was achieved by the SAARC? The establishment of SAARC, preferential trading agreement, and reduction in tariff and non-tariff barriers on imports. In imports, tariff means already I told you tax, isn't it? They reduced the tax for tax, otherwise given the tax itself. Now that means they are not allotted the tax itself for the imports through this SAARC. The setting up of technical committees for economic cooperation among SAARC countries relating to agriculture, communication, education, health and population, rural development, science and technology, tourism, etc. For everything, what they did, that they started the technical committees in the member countries of the SAARC. SAARC has established a three-tier mechanism for exchanging information on poverty reduction programs, which is passed on to member countries. Most probably the SAARC, what they did there, they eradicate the poverty in all the member countries. SAARC Agricultural Information Center in 1988 works as a central information institution for agriculture related resources like fisheries, forestry, everything. Agriculture only, fisheries, forestry. Agriculture means what? Growing something, isn't it? That means we are saying only the growing crops, not like that. Growing crops is called as a farming. Growing fishery is there. Growing the forestry is there. Growing the honeybees are there. Everything comes under the agriculture alone. Everything, it was done in the excellent manner through the SAARC. South Asian Development Fund for development projects, human resource development and infrastructure development progress. It was launched for the development projects, South Asian Development Fund. With all these tall claims, the inter-SAARC trade has not gone beyond 3% in the last 30 years. Okay, children, thank you.